By the time men were walking on the moon, Langley advances in safety and performance had been incorporated into a new generation of aircraft. One such breakthrough was development of a variable sweep wing, a wing that could be adjusted to different angles for either subsonic or supersonic flight. Langley tests resulted in production of the nation's first variable sweep fighter, the F-111. Variable sweep wings are also used by the B-1 and the F-14. Research in cryogenics led to the development of a new kind of wind tunnel in the 70s. Using cold gaseous nitrogen as a test medium, Langley's National Transonic Facility became a way to bridge the Reynolds number gap at transonic speeds. And Langley's Richard Widcomb continued a remarkable career of invention with a new wing shape, a supercritical wing to delay the onset of drag at high subsonic speeds. Widcomb later showed how winglets, small airfoils attached to the end of an airplane wing, could increase fuel economy and reduce cost. Langley began research on development of a supersonic transport and continued study of vertical and short takeoff and landing aircraft. Langley tested aircraft tires and runway grooving at the landing loads track, and the Lunar Lander Research Facility was reborn to study airplane crashes to increase pilot and passenger survival.